Good morning, friends. Myself, Pokhara HP, Department of Zoology, the TYPSC, the paper is the parasitology. That is the study of the different parasites. Parasite, it is the organism that depends on the food, shelter, nourishment on the other animal. That is the process of this phenomena is called as the parasitism. Host and the parasite correlate to each other. Host is the larger animal. Parasite is the smaller animal. For the purpose of the food, shelter, nourishment, they depends on the host. That is, in that, the study of the different parasites. They study the different disease and the disease transported one individual to the another individual. In the world, number of these animals, including the phylum Arthropoda, there are the particularly class insecta. These animals play an important role of the vectors. Vector means they transfer the pathogen from one individual to another individual. At that time, these are called as the biological vector, because at the time of the transporting, they transfer different type of the pathogen from one individual to the another individual. That is the, these are the disease, means disorder. What is meant by disease? There are the loss of ease. They are the loss of ease, and this phenomenon is called as the disease, that is the influence of the human health, and they are the ability to function get damaged. That is the disease caused by the parasites. There are the several type of the parasite causes the different diseases. That is, the disease may be affected to the productivity of the animal, production of the food, as well as the such as the bird, dairy cows, as well as the number of these animals. There are the cows, number of the parasites are present. Due to the heavy impact of the parasite, the dairy product is production of the milk get declined. That is, all these animals affected by these parasites. And actually, this parasite is the smaller animal, the different. That is, the some animal produce the disease, zoonotic diseases. That is, the disease transfer from wild animal to the domesticated animal. And that is, this in the wild animal population, the reduced by the disease can be upset to the ecological balance of the area. That is, main thing, then the animal, they cause the number of these diseases are characterized by infection of some of the non-infectious, some of the infectious agents, such as the agent means these are the bacteria, viruses, while some are the non-infectious agents caused by the factors such as the diet, environment, injury, heredity. There are the number of these animal they get infected, and these are the combination of the disease is at one time. That is, they identify the disease better prevention first determine the animal species, breeding, age, sex. At that time, there are the this number of these environmental factors get affected. There are the temperature, humidity. Sometimes the animal are infected by this pathogen. At that time, they get the physical examination, and that is, these are the affected. Sometimes some other smaller organisms, that is the fungal culture growth. In that, larger number of these animals are developed. Means in that animal, study the different type of the parasites. They present in the human body. At that time, they make a disease. This parasite is affected to the human. Sometimes heavy infection due to the death. There are the one more very important animal we have studied. This animal commonly called as the head louse. These are the head louse, biologically known as Pediculus humanus capitis. That is, this head louse is a very important animal, considering to the introduction. These are the animals are the entirely of the parasites. These are the found to the outer surface of the body. These animals include into the suborder, particularly Pithera. That is, in that animal, suborder is the flora included three different type of the sucking lice. Three different type of the lice, that is, they suck the blood, and these which are the one of these ectoparasites. There are the three different species, particularly all are the sucking lice, suck the blood of the human. That is, we three, one is called the head louse, Pediculus humanus capitis, present into the human body. Second is the body louse,
principal at the pediculus corporis. That is the plant house, and the third one is the petirus pubic. They present into the pubic, or it is also commonly called as the crab lice. That is, these three lice are the blood sucking lice. These are the ectoparasite of the man. That is, these three pieces found in the human body, external surface of the body. That is very commonly known as the ectoparasites. Attached to the body, they are the different part of the body. They present into the skin, hair, cloth, and at the time of the feeding mechanism, they inserted the mouth part in the human skin. And they suck the blood one by one. That is, these are the introduction. That is, this is all main thing is that this head louse is the blood sucking ectoparasites. These are particularly sanguivorous animals. What is meant by sanguivorous? They are the continuously sucking the blood. That is, in a one day, 6 to 8 times they continuously the blood. That is, they are the systematic position. That is the classification. These head louse, they are classified into which different categories. That is, these are the one thing is the kingdom Animalia, because it is the animal. These are the food, the bone food. These animal food is called the kingdom Animalia. These animals are included into the kingdom Animalia. Second is the sub kingdom Metazoa. Why it is called as the Metazoa? Because body is developed by the multicellular body. These animals are the multicellular organelle in different systems are well developed. That's why it's called the kingdom Metazoa. Next one is the phylum Arthropoda. That is, these are the largest animal group. And particularly in that animal, the body is divided into the three parts: head, thorax, and the abdomen. That's why these animals in the world, largest animal are included in this phylum. That is, these animals are also included in the phylum Arthropoda. Next one is the subphylum Mandibulata. That is, the mouth part is the mandibulate. Modified mouth parts are present. That's why these are included into the subphylum Mandibulata. Class Insecta. That is, under the phylum Arthropoda, these are the biggest class. They are the in that animal. That is, these are the also known as the Hexapoda. Three pair of the legs are present. These legs present in the thoracic region. First pair is present in the prothorax, second is present in the mesothorax, and third is called as the metathorax. That is, each thoracic region on the ventral side, there are one pair is present in each thoracic region, means six legs, three pair of the legs are present. That's why this animal is included in the class Insecta. Subclass of Pterygota, that is the means pterygota means. That is, in that animal, absence of the wings. That is, these are the group. No wings are present, but cursorial type of the legs are present. Running type of the legs are present. These animals move on the surface of the cloth, on the part of the hair. That is, the legs are the fully modified. There are the order Pteroptera. That is, in that order, that is the Ptera means there are the wings are totally absent. Body, abdomen is the segmented family, pediculate. That is, in that animal, that is the sexual dimorphisms are present, and particularly these are the easily identified according to the morphological characters. Genus is the Pediculus. And that is, in that animal, these are the blood sucking animal, and the particularly species is, that is the humanus. That is the genetically called as the Pediculus humanus. Biologically, it is also called as the Capitus. That is, these are the classification they are included in this point. This is the next one is the geographical distribution. That is, in that animal, where they are distributed in the world, which locality, which country, which region they get, however, and then they go to the which region. That is the geographical distribution. That is, this human life is the cosmopolitan animal. Cosmopolitan means they are distributed in the worldwide. In the every region of the world, these animals are found in the all races of the people. Particularly, these are the more abundant in the crowded people. crowded means in the particular locality, large number of the population stay in the very less place. That is the crowded region. Basically, the unhygienic people. That is, these are unhygienic human habitats. That is, in some people they are the uncareless for the body, uncareless of the habitats. That is not a regular bathing. There are the body careless. That is unhygienic people. Uncrowded people means in the big city, very less places, number of the people they are overcrowding. That is, in that region they are the particularly developed. Means sometimes in the army camps as well as the labor camps, these body lovers is the more in number. That is, these are the number is distributed according to the environmental condition. That is, in the tropical countries, temperate region, then amount of the population is the less amount. That is, this region where the people are used very less amount of the cloth. That's why these animal population in the tropical temperate region, there are the very less amount. But in that colder region, that is the people, they use large amount of the clothing, warm clothing, they change the impurity. That time, this is the cold region, use the large amount of the cloth due to the warming condition. In that locality, large amount of the population is excessive. Means in the temperate region, the population of the hemlocks is less. In the colder region, the population of the hemlocks is the larger in number. And actually, in this, that is the hemlocks is the commonly in the warm areas. That is, these are the one facial region. Actually, they are the region attributed to the most frequently. And actually, next one is the habit and the habitat. That is, in that animal, some peculiar characters. That is, in that animal, there are where they are located, which habit, and there are the which habitats are created. These animals are the very small. These are the wingless ectoparasites found into the man bodies. Second one is the sanguivorous animal. What is meant by sanguivorous? Sanguivorous means these animals are the voracious feeder, continuously blood sucking. Means in one day, 6 to 8 times the continuously the adult larva, these are the continuously blood meal they get sucking. That is the every 6 to 8 times puncture the skin through the mouth part and the suck the blood. That is, these are the sanguivorous ectoparasites are present. And severally, they are the living the parasite. That is, the life cycle of this insect is completed in the host of the human body. That is, the human is the definitive host. Whole life cycle is completed in the human body. There are 3 different types of the hemlocks. That is, there are the, this lies habitated in the distinct part of the host body. There are the, according to this part, that is the first one is called the pedicludus humanus capitis. These are the lived in the skin, lived in the hair, as well as the hair of the head. Second one is called the pedicludus corporis. That is, these are called as the lived in the clothing lungs. They are the particularly upon the skin and they feed upon the hold of the adjusting part of the clothing. As well as these are the legs are released in the seam of the clothing. That is, this is called as the clothing lungs. And the third one is the pedicludus pubic, or it is also called as the pubic lungs. It is found in the pubic region or the perineal region. That is, it may be occurs in the other part of the body. That is, in that animal, generally these 3 different lines, they are located into the different pedicludus humanus found into the skin. Here, this corpora is found into the clothing and pubic lungs found into the pubic region of the perineal region. That is, which locality they are easily survived. That is, the temperature is the important factor. That is, these animals are survive in the moderate temperature. The temperature range is the 29 degrees centigrade to the 30 degrees centigrade. They are easily survived. And that is, these are the temperature is the favorable for the growth of these hemlocks. As well as the humidity on the depends on the human body. The temperature is below particularly 20 degrees centigrade or the above the 40 degrees centigrade, this lies away from the host. Means temperature is declined below the 20 degree, that time the lice present into the host body, this new from the host. Or that this host temperature is the rises the body. They are introduced to the 40 degree centigrade. They also away from the host body. That is, these are the range. These are the not a favorable part of this heat loss. These are animal particularly eggs development is stopped in the below the temperature is the 23 degree centigrade. That is the 23 degree centigrade temperature is range. Below this range, the egg hatching is stopped. As well as above the 37 degree centigrade, these are the not favorable for the hatching. That is, in that temperature, that is the above the 23 degree centigrade and below the 37. That is the 23 to 37, this temperature range. That is, these are the favorable for the growth of the animal. That is, in that temperature region, this egg hatch to the larva, that is called as the nymph. And in that region, this animal are easily survived. That is, these are the animal in the very crowding and they are more serve the blood of the hormone.